Hello, this is Missionary Paulie B with Sonship Lifestyle University coming back at you. Today, I'm going to give you four tips and strategies that you can use while out on the streets. I know you've been watching a lot of our videos. We're putting out a healing. We're seeing healings, you know, when we're going out in the streets and doing things, people's shoulders and knees and backs and legs growing, seeing all sorts of amazing things happening. But sometimes we're looking for creative ideas that we can do this, you know, and I did a video not too long ago and gave some tips and strategies and ideas and stuff you could do to break the ice and how to break the ice. And I gave you a couple tips for approaching people, you know, and how to do some setups. I love setups. Well, in this video, I want to give you some tips and strategies that you can use to be able to do with a team, to be able to get people together, to be able to do something like in a group, right? And I like groups, especially if you have people that are experienced and unexperienced, because it gives an opportunity for everybody to be involved and everybody to be able to see what's happening and what's going on. So these four things are just some of the ideas. I mean, I got a lot of them, but let me just give you these four, and I think you could use them, and they will help you so much. Because a lot of times you're trying to think about, you know, ways that you could take teams out in to the streets and the highways and byways, how you can be able to get attention, and how you can make, you know, massive action in the streets, right? That's what we want. At the end of the day, we want massive action. Like, we want to see results, right? That's, I mean, everybody wants to see it. Like, we can't lie. We want to see results. So I want to give you ideas and tips and strategies that will bring people together and get you the results that you're looking for to help, especially those people that you're training and equipping to have encounters, right, that they can grow, and also those who are seasoned. It gives you an opportunity to sow into their life and train as well. It gives them that haven't had a lot of experience an opportunity to see you in action. They can see what it looks like, right? So one tip I want to say before I get started into these ideas is I want to encourage you, if you are a person who has experience, okay, and you've been doing this and you got people that don't have experience, remember you are the teacher. Try to do a lot of creative things that will set people up to be able to have encounters, to be able to lay hands on people, to pray for people, to do the doing, right? At the end of the day, we want people to have these encounters and these experiences so that they can be able to see that, hey, Jesus still does this work through our hands, right? That's what we want to do. We want to give people this encounter and this opportunity, right? So, like, when people come to my home, I have people that come and live for a week long in my home. When they come, I get people from different variety and variations of life. Listen, I even get pastors that we've trained in our schools that have never even went into the streets and done any kind of street ministry, right? So it's even new to some people that have been in the Christian circle for a long time. And a lot of times the uncomfortability comes from lack of experience, not being around people who do it or know how to do it or know how to make it easy for us, right? So there's everybody's in different places, and that's okay. But if you're experienced, make sure to understand that you're the teacher. You're setting up as many opportunities as you can for people. Every time you can break the ice, every time you set up an opportunity, make sure to get your team members involved. Make sure to get them a part of this, right? So they can have that encounter. They can have that experience, right? You don't want them just sitting around watching you do it all. Yes, they're going to get a little bit of that, and that's okay. Nothing wrong with that. But at the end of the day, we want them in the game. We don't want them on the sidelines just watching the game play out. We want to make sure that we get them into the game. That's what a good coach does. He makes sure he gets players into the game, makes sure he utilizes his team, and that's what we do when we go onto the streets. So these four tips I'm going to give you today are going to help you to be able to utilize your team, to use them, to train them, and actually is going to help be able to create avenues that you can draw people that will just come to you. Like, I mean, wouldn't that be cool? Like, where you wouldn't have to necessarily focus so much energy on trying to get the icebreaker, but you could create the icebreaker where people just come to you. Wouldn't that be awesome? I mean, this is really what we really want at the end of the day. So this is something that I like to do, and I want to give you four things. One thing is, depending on your setup, but let's just say you have a place that's close to you where you have, like, in a city, like New York City, for example, or Washington, D.C., or Las Vegas, or somewhere where there's a lot of people around, right? So, like, in Las Vegas, they're there to be entertained. When you go to the Big Apple and you're right downtown in the Big Apple, you know, they're there to be entertained. They want to be seen. They want to be noticed. They want to see what's going on. They want to be a part of this whole thing. So one of the things I like to do with our team is I'll set up a chair right in the middle of, like, right down in Vegas, like right in the strip. We'll be down like a Fremont experience. We'll throw a chair out there. You might even rent a spot right there. Throw a chair in there. When you put the chair there, you get somebody on your team, you set them down in the chair, you grab their legs, you start, even if their legs are normal, you start growing their legs in and out, and you're allowing people to come around. The rest of your team, what they're doing is they're staying around, either one clapping or cheering, or they're telling people who are walking by, like, hey, come check this out. Have you seen this before? Like, this is really cool. Can you believe what's happening? And you're getting people to come in. So say, for an example, let me set the scene for you. Let's just say you have 10 people, okay? So what you'll do is you'll take two of those 10 people and you'll put one in a chair. You'll have one person to grow on the legs for the moment. You'll put the other 8 people around those 2 people, okay? So what they're doing is they're, like, cheering it on. They're watching, like, you know, and then they're also, as people are walking by, they're saying, hey, can you check this out? I want you to see this. Have you ever seen anything like this? So what they do is they end up bringing that person in. Now, as people come into the circle, what happens is you want to begin, you and your team want to begin to step back and let the people come into the circle and watch, okay? So they're coming in and they're watching what's going on. Now, this works really well in the Big Apple. This works really well. There's a lots of people where people are wanting to be entertained. Las Vegas is the best to do this, right? We do this in Las Vegas. Works every time. It's amazing. And so what you do is you just put the chair, get them in there. They want to be entertained. They're coming in to watch. They're seeing what's happening. You get your naysayers. You get your yays. You get your nays. You get all that involved. That's what makes the whole thing fun, especially when you get the people that are critics. That makes it a lot of fun. And then once you get your critics doing it, right, and then they're saying, well, they're pulling the leg. And then you get them down there, and their leg's growing, and they're not pulling anything. Now explain it. What now, right? And it makes it a lot of fun. It's just a blast. You know, and then we'll set the legs out sometimes on chairs, and we won't even have them put their hands on it, and we'll call the leg out. And especially when you get critics doing it, it makes it so much fun. The crowd comes around because the hecklers are heckling, and then the hecklers are doing it, and then the people around are, like, amazed. Well, what happens is your team's all around them, and they're watching this whole thing take place. So as people are watching and engaging, somebody might leave the circle. And as they do, what happens is one of your team members, they grab that person and say, hey, what did you think about that? Do you got anything going on in your body? Back, shoulders, knees, pain? So what happens is you created the scene. You created the whole scenario. You're letting people actually get to see this thing happen. And people are coming to you. I mean, it's the easiest icebreaker out there. It's really super fun. It's engaging, something you can do with your team. That's tip number one. Tip number two is you can create a place anywhere. Most likely you want to put it in a place where there's some traffic, right? But maybe free hot dogs, free water. You do something like that, giving away free hot dogs, free water. People are coming up as they're coming up. When they come, you just ask them, is there anything we pray for you for? You got any pain in your body, back, shoulders, knees? Give prophetic words. It's a great way to be able to break the ice. You just got to find the right place. You got to make sure in your location and area if you need permits and all that kind of stuff. You know, just make sure you get all that figured out. But at the end of the day, these are ways you can do outreaches that get people coming to you. Well, you're not always having to go out there and figure out how to break the ice, especially when you got a group of people. This is what I love to do when I get groups of people. I don't want to split the group up because at the end of the day, the group wants to learn. So I want to get as many of my team members that know how to do this stuff together. And then I want to create scenarios that I can get everybody that's come to watch all of us do it. And then I want to put them into the game and doing it, right? So these are ways that I create these scenarios. So one, we do the chair. We do them in busy places. Two, we'll do hot dogs and water, right? We'll get people coming up. They're getting hot dogs. They're getting free water. We're talking to them. We're making friendships. We're asking if they got anything going on, back, shoulders, knees. We give them prophetic words. These are the different things that we do that you can do right in your neighborhood to make a huge difference. The next thing you can do is a free car wash. Free car washes are awesome. Like, Don't charge anything. Absolutely free. Get a group of 10, 15 people and create a car wash. People will come in. They're free. You're washing. They're going to ask what it's for and just say, hey, it's absolutely free. We're just loving on people. We're praying for people. We're believing. Have water. Give them water while they're there. You know, we're praying. Is there anything we pray for you for? You got any pain? You got anybody in your family? And you're just ministering and loving on people, right, at this time. Now, if you have a ministry, a group, or church, this is time you want flyers, brochures, stuff like that you can give to them so you can follow up with them. And if you can set up an appointment at these things. This is another great thing, is I always tell the people that we're doing these in their area, like, make sure to have a way to connect with these guys, because when they have an encounter, you don't want to just leave them with the encounter. You want to create a way that you can follow up with that person, right? So you want to give them like a card, you want to give them a flyer, a brochure, and then what you're going to do is you're going to say, hey, at that moment, what day is a good day me and you can go have coffee? That's what you do. You set the appointment right there. See, the key is you get the appointment now, not later. Don't wait for them to call. You set the appointment now. Then you get their phone number. Makes it simple, easy, because you got their phone number. You got them right there, and everything happens and runs from there. Okay? And then this is another thing. The other thing is in the car wash, you can also put things together to give away free stuff. Like I said, you can give away waters. You can give away anything you want to get. Just find some things that are really cool little giveaways. If you have kids, have little toys for the kids. You know, have water bottles for the parents. Just any little thing, it'd be simple to give away. So we're going to give it away. We're going to give away prayer. We're going to give away healing. We're giving it all away in a free car wash. It's a great way for people to get touched and blessed, right? So if you want them to get out of the car, what you want to do is you want to set like a little space next to the car wash and just say, hey, these guys are going to wash your car. Hey, we got some free water bottles. You know, we got free sandwiches, free chips, free ice cream, you know, whatever it is you want to do. You know, put popcorn, free slushies, anything. They kids get little toys. Get them out of the car. Then you can have the opportunity to minister them. That's a great way to be able to create an atmosphere that you can sow into people and bless people, right? Number four, I call pain or pay. This is like a game show game that we love to do. We do this all the time in the streets, and it's a lot of fun in places that where people are going to be entertained. Las Vegas, Big Apple, you know, you go, if you're going out to New Orleans, you know, during Mardi Gras, or you're going down into spring break stuff. You go where there's a lot of action going on, right? So these are great little things you can do. So this is a little game we end up playing. It's called Pain or Play. And so what we end up doing is we take a $20 bill, and then we go around, we tell people, look, we're looking for people who got pain. And if you got pain and the pain does not go away, I'm going to give you this $20 bill, right? You'll be surprised, because I know what you're thinking right now. You're like, well, of course, they're going to do whatever they can get to $20 bill. You will be surprised. I have a video on my YouTube. You have to go check it out. I'll see if I can find the link and I'll put it on here. But in my YouTube channel is Missionary Pauly B. It's on my YouTube. This video is awesome. You watch this lady that was from Oregon. Matter of fact, she was from my neck of the woods, but she was in Vegas at this time. And we are playing this game, and her friends come up. She just, like, she lost something. She didn't have no money anyways, long story short. And so we told her this. Well, she ended up having pain in her body, right? And so she initially later says that she was going to, like was thinking about the $20, but she got healed, and it rocked her, right? So, like, she was totally healed. She fell on the ground. She's bawling. She just had this massive encounter with the Holy Spirit. It was amazing just watching this thing unfold. It was just crazy encounter. Long story short, what we do when we do this is we might have a team of maybe, oh, like say 10 people, 15 people, 20 people, and each person will bring maybe $20, right? And so we take all the $20. So what happens is this, guys. This is the cool thing about the game. Whether the pain goes away or does not go away, we still give them the $20, right? It's not about money. They get the money anyways. We just do it because that's what we do as sons. We give, right? So we're always about giving in their needs. So at the end of the day, we know in the back of our heart, we're giving it to them anyways, right? But she's like, no, We had another scenario in San Francisco where my buddy Antonio Torones Jr. was doing it on the street, and the lady would not take the $20 because she got healed. She was like, no, I don't need, I needed that. I needed that healing is what I needed. That money ain't even compared to what I just got. She was just, it was just amazing to watch. Matter of fact, he kept trying to say, hey, we give it away anyways. We want to bless you. So she took it, grabbed it, gave it to the person behind her and blessed that person. So man, that's what it's all about, right? Is giving kingdom encounters with people, let them experience the love of God. Guys, these are four tips and strategies that you can use to be able to make a difference in your community to help the people around you. So I hope these helped you. If they do, please take a moment, click and share this video with a friend if you think it'll help anybody and give us some tips and strategies. I also want to give you a heads up real quick about the school in our home. We have a school coming up May 7th through the 13th. I have four other schools the rest of the year. You can go to sonshipuniversity.com and get that information right there in our in-home school where you come and live with us. We pick you up at the airport. We drop you back off at the airport. You live with us. We feed you. We take care of you. Matter of fact, if you can't, if you don't want to pay to come to the school and you want to get your own motel, you want to get your own rental car, your own food, it'll cost about $1,000, $1,100. You can do that and you still come to the school for free, right? Because it's not about paying to come to the school. I'm not about that, right? But at the end of the day, you know, it does cost $525. If you want to stay in my home, I will provide all the food. I'll pick you up at the airport. I'll drop you off at the airport. You can sleep right here in our house. We can have fellowship, break bread together, live together. It's amazing, right? So whatever you want to do, whatever floats your boat, at the end of the day, most people want to come and stay with us and hang out with us. So guys, I want to give you that invitation to come and live right here in our home with us. So guys, I just want to give that shout out, that sonshipuniversity.com. And go get registered. You go about halfway down there. You'll see my book in there. Guys, all these tips and strategies, there's so much more in my book. Make sure to get a copy of my book as well. So thank you guys for watching this. Thank you for sharing this. Have an amazing day in Jesus. Thank you, Casey, for watching this. I appreciate you, sister. Michael, thank you for coming on. You guys are amazing. Joseph from Canada, how you doing, brother? Love you, man. Have an amazing day, guys. God bless.